It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And on this week's show, it's the second week of our Fism highlights. We had a great time at Fism, but just before, we see some more interviews from star lecturers and dealers bringing out products at Fism.
We have a huge announcement.
Well, it's LADS. On the 30th of September, we've got the LADS convention once again.
It's in its third year. Every year, we try to make it bigger and better than the year before. And over the next few weeks, we're going to be announcing some of the star lecturers that are going to be appearing at LADS.
And first of all, we're going to announce one star name. The star lecturer at LADS this year is the one and only Francis Minotti.
Now, if you watched the show a few weeks ago and saw our review of his Treachery of Tricks, I think it's one of the best DVDs that have come out in the last 10 years. It's incredibly influential. And as soon as we saw the DVD, we knew we had to get Francis.
We wanted him for LADS. We've tracked him down. We've secured him with contracts, 100 pages long and that kind of thing. He's flying over just for the LADS convention.
And he is amazing. I don't think he's ever done a major convention before.
No.
In the UK, and you really don't want to miss his lecture and his performance.
We will be announcing other lecturers, but we're going to start off by announcing Francis Minotti for LADS 30th of September. It's on the website now. We are limited to 300 places. Last year, sold out. It's on with the Fism highlights.
This guy is amazing. He made condoms cool. Yeah, he really did.
And we will say no more. We will just welcome to the Wizard Product Review sofa the legend that is David Stone.
Woo-hoo! Come in, David.
Hi, guys.
Hey, it's good to have you, David. Fantastic to be here.
Great to meet you at last. We love your book. We love your DVD. We love you. I tell you what, I'm going to have one of those fanboy moments right now.
I'm really happy. Me, I have to tell you, I love your wife, so we have a common point. Thank you.
I actually don't have a wife anymore, and it's a really sore subject.
Really?
I'm really upset about it.
I made a mistake.
I have my dog, Blammo. Do you love Blammo?
I like everything, actually. I'm French enough for that.
Actually, talking about being French, I'm in deadly serious now. The biggest buzz in Fism seems to be around anything that's French.
French magicians.
Like, last week we had on Joke and the coin guys and everything that's like all the buzz in the dealer room. It's all about all the guys that are bringing out products, like the red button thing and all these
Mickael
guys.
Mickael Chatelain.
All the French guys seem to be taking over Fism.
I've read a lot of things about the fucking coins, DVD.
It's amazing.
It's amazing that I haven't seen the DVD yet.
It's really good.
At least if people want to speak about it, that's perfect.
You know, yeah. I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. So, words, you have words out at the
yeah,
the
words is something a bit different. It's less polemical, but it's funny.
Yeah, you don't really...
It's about mentalism. Normally, I don't really do mentalism, actually. But I love it the way that the creators, Stéphane Gecko and Johan Tanuji, created words. It's for the first time a book test where you have nothing, and I mean it, nothing, to remember. Nothing. All you have to do is to read on the back of the main book, and you can instantly say the words the people are thinking.
That's great.
It's not like a mentalist book, a book test. You usually have to remember at least 24 or 25.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
Words by heart. But this one, you have nothing to do, and other professional. I don't have time to spend 6 months on learning something that might be obsolete a few weeks ago because a new trick will release.
Yeah.
That's why words, I take it, I read it, and 5 minutes later, I can perform it.
And what's really cool about it is it's built into a word search book. So it's really, really organic. I've always seen these guys that go table hopping and they carry around like a big dictionary. He carries around a dictionary. Mm-hmm. But it's a pocket
right in a stage size, show.
Exactly. Yeah, but in a close-up gig,
it's
a pocket-sized word search book. It's the sort of thing that you would have on you.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
Cool.
Really
and
good
when I do it, I also use sometimes a pocket dictionary.
Okay.
Very tiny dictionary, and then I can also do the tricks with the dictionary, you know, the end when you do
it. And do you have anything else out at Fism?
I have a new trick, but I keep it only for me, not for dealers yet.
Right, okay.
It's called the Misdirection Deck, and I will perform it at Fism. I like when people come to my lecture, they have something they can't have anywhere else.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you thank them for coming to
Philly. Lectures, I remember your lecture at Blackpool a few years ago where you produced the dancing girls in close-up.
Yeah, two girls.
And you had the strippers hidden on the under the table for like an hour.
Yeah, it cost
that,
me
just
an hour.
For the finale.
Yeah, that's one thing I've noticed about your lecturing. When you do a lecture compared to a lot of other people, you make the lecture a show.
Yeah.
It's like you put bits in there just to make people laugh. And it's a lot of lecturers don't do that, but it makes it so much more entertaining.
A lot of people are saying to me this week things they're looking forward to, and constantly I've heard the Michael Weber lecture and David Stone's lecture.
Yeah.
It's all I've heard all week that people are looking
forward to. It's important to me to make lecture not only funny. The most important for me is if people are happy, they will learn faster.
Yeah.
You know, so, and the concentration is 45 minutes. You can't ask people to be focused on something more than 45 minutes. So what I try to do is to keep their attention for 45 minutes, and for 30 minutes, I do jokes and gags to make them relax, you know. So at the end of my lecture, they feel they had a good time. Only, but when they're home, they remember almost every trick I've done without him, you know what I mean? It was not a difficult experience. It was funny, entertaining experience.
Mm-hmm.
But my point is to make them remember some of the important tricks I want them to remember, or the lessons.
That's a good idea.
Well, we certainly remember your performances. A lot of your effects have kind of become instant classics.
Oh,
Do you think you could perform something now for the Wizard Product Review viewers?
Well, yeah,
Can we get it off the sticks for John?
Yeah, I can. Do you mind if I stand just to the studio to show you?
Stand up, yeah.
Actually, this is one of my most famous classic tricks. As I used to do it a lot of times. And as a French guy, I like to offer things to people. So I can take maybe just a balloon.
Yeah, a balloon.
And I need a pair of scissors. I think I might have one pair of scissors. Yeah. And I, and oh, I'm sorry, I mean, maybe it's not the, I double it if you want. Double the splash for the match. You have one for each of you.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Je m'appelle Craig.
Et Mickael, enchanté.
Oui. j'habite au Chatelain.
Et j'habite en France, à Reims.
Mm-hmm. Chatelain est au centre d'Angleterre, près de Birmingham.
Et je suis né à Paris, en France.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Kind of screwed now.
That's a bit more correct.
Can you show us your new trick?
Yes, my new trick.
Yes, you go.
Good. I didn't understand that last bit. I couldn't understand that last bit.
It's my new trick, my new DVD and Alcatraz box. Okay.
Because you've bought
Hole,
out.
I was gonna say Hole was great.
Yeah.
And you know, just to prove it is Michael, there's his hands. Look, because on the trailer, this is all you saw, his hands doing the trick. Yeah.
Okay, can you?
Pendant le tour, on ne voit uniquement que tes mains.
Okay.
Et ce sont bien tes mains pour Hall qui est vraiment incroyable.
Ah oui, oui c'est...
Yeah, so you're, we're going to see him all doing the trick this time. So this is Alcatraz box?
Yeah, three routines inside with a gimmick and a new effect, okay? You love Hall?
Yes, Hall's good, yeah.
And you love Alcatraz box, okay?
Yeah.
Already. Ready. Are you sure?
And it's out in August worldwide. So this is kind of like a sneak preview. Only the people that have paid to visit Fism have got to see this.
Yeah.
And you know, and so this is the first time you're going to see this.
Yeah.
On the Wizard
Product
Review.
Because you've bought out so many gimmick products and products with really cool funky gimmicks and it's just amazing. So yeah,
we can't wait to see.
Go for it.
Okay. Free routine, ambitious card, color deck, and change card. Inside, I perform ambitious card. Okay?
Okay.
Do you need John to get it off the sticks?
Say, get it off the sticks.
Oh, just put zoom in the box. Okay?
Oh, no, let him get it off the sticks. He likes getting off the sticks.
Focus on the
hole, John.
It's not the first time you said that.
This is a special box, okay? Nothing inside, yeah?
Okay.
Can you examine nothing in the box?
There's nothing in there.
Okay.
Just like holes drilled.
And this is my deck.
John, this is his deck.
Yeah, this is a deck. Okay.
Craig is a
deck. Well,
take,
it's been said.
Take any card.
Any card?
Yeah, really. and show the camera, please. And can you sign a card on the face, please?
Yeah. Don't look, Ben.
Yeah?
Look over there.
No, it's not important.
Okay. Yeah. You can look. He's seen the trick before, Craig. Yeah. He knows how to do it.
Oh, a picture.
Is that a problem?
Yeah, it's not a good choice. I je n'aime pas en plus celle-ci.
He doesn't like this one.
Yeah, really?
It's, do you want me to throw it away?
Yeah.
Wow.
take another one.
Yeah?
Oh, crap.
No, Jack. No.
No. I got to say, your there classic force is crap. Michael,
no.
It really is.
Really, a free choice. Really, really.
Yeah. Is that one okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Free choice. Yeah, really. Just told us. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Okay.
Not that one. Not that one. This will do.
Five of clubs.
I like the psychology. Five of clubs. Kind of deep.
In the dick. Okay. Lost in the dick. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And nothing in the box. All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know you. Already. I've seen. Yeah, but I've you know this man. You know what he's like. He's got like flaps and lips and flops.
No, isn't. I've checked.
Okay. The dick, in the box.
Yeah. Okay. That's fine.
Sorry. Okay.
Yeah, that's fair.
No manipulation. Okay.
Okay.
Your card in the deck in the box. Okay.
Yeah.
Look.
What? No.
One, two, three.
What
one card.
What the hell?
Happier. Here. Ambitious card. Ambitious card.
Yes? How the hell did you do that?
In first position, one card is your card. Yes. And you can examine deck. Yeah. Ready? In the box. Nothing in the box. Yeah.
Je m'appelle Mickael. There's nothing in that box.
WTF? What, I don't get it. I don't understand how that works.
That's amazing.
That's brilliant.
So this is
like we had.
This is ambitious card.
Yeah, yeah.
What are the other tricks you can do with the same thing? Yeah.
Yeah. Color change. Color change. A spectator take any cards. Any cards. Sign your card. The deck, the card in the deck, the deck in the box. Imagine the deck is red. One, two, three. The deck change a color. Blue deck, really blue deck. 51 cards, blue card. Just only one card is red. A spectator card. So routine number two is color deck. And my favorite routine, change card. Just only one card. My favorite card is Queen of Spades. Queen of Spades. In the box. Just only one card, my card, in the box. A spectator take any card, and my card change in the spectator card, in the box. Coming soon.
In August. Thank you very much for showing us that. That's kind of like an exclusive for the Wizard Product Review viewers. That's brilliant, isn't it, Craig?
That is honestly amazing. You see so many of these... ambitious cards with that, like the hawk, you know. But this is just so much, so much better.
I have no idea how that worked, genuinely.
I genuinely have no idea how that, I'm just totally, completely fooled.
Thank you very much.
Is it going into your number one set, Craig?
This is going straight into my number one set.
There we go, straight into the number one set. So one of the problems with Fism is you tend to run into people that you may have, like, kind of upset.
And we tend to upset quite a lot of people
on
the show.
Well, it's because we're honest.
We're completely honest. We say what we think. You know. And not long ago on the show, we talked about the super latex hammer and how it's not very super and it's obviously latex.
Yeah.
And, you know, the
kinda
guy that
gave it a bit of a trashing.
Yeah, real trashing. And
then we were walking through the dealer hall today and this guy was running after us with a real hammer.
Yeah, he was.
And
it was rather disconcerting, to be honest.
Yeah, and he pinned us in the corner and said he was actually going to show us how real this hammer was.
And he wanted a chance to come on the show.
Unless he came on tonight.
Yeah, and so we had really no choice. So our next guest on the Wizard Product Review, please welcome Mr. Twister Magic himself,
George Iglesias.
Hello.
Hello, George.
Wait. No. There is a candle that transforms into a rose. Oh, nice. Happening every time.
That's wonderful. You know, 2 years ago in this very hotel, Matthew Bick threatened to kill me because I called him an idiot. I'd just like to point out, I didn't actually
call you an idiot.
No, I didn't call you an idiot.
We are okay in that part.
Let me just tell you as well, George.
Yeah.
We did give you a very good review for Dollar to Credit Card.
I know, he did it really well.
And food to go.
We start with the positives.
I know. I can't complain. Yeah.
But come on, let's talk about this hammer first. I mean, come on.
All right. Is it the real one, right, Nelson? Okay.
The real one.
Yeah. So who want to be first? Okay. So, well, basically, I was upset, and it's good that you give me the chance to be on the show. Very kind of you. It is a fact that I didn't disagree with all the stuff that you said. I just think that you, as reviewers of a TV show, I mean, like this, that thousands of people are watching you,
yeah.
And I told you that in advance, in a certain way, you want it or you don't, you hold a responsibility, same as a TV host or a news program, right, on a TV channel when they express opinions.
Yeah.
Because rather you might, in the right or a wrong point, people will follow you.
I agree with all this so far.
So you hold the responsibility. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If something's rubbish, people deserve to know.
Of course. This is basically a gag. However, you can do many things with it. Remember, you are examining
mentalism routine.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, come on, yeah,
you
yeah.
Can.
It says on the box.
How many people?
It looks.
Make,
hang on. I don't know. Did you do fractions
yeah.
at school?
It looks 100% real.
It looks
100%
real.
You know how many times I have
100%.
But this is not a close-up trick. Hello, dudes, you are missing the point. This is not a closure trick. You gotta be on stage. You gotta have this hidden. You can do a switch for a real one that looks like this one.
Natural brilliance.
Which
and
means
realism.
the material of the super
natural
latex
brilliance
of,
and realism. Mm-hmm. Realism.
Realism, yeah.
It looks 100% real. I'm sorry, but it doesn't have brackets that says on stage.
Alright.
It just
so
says
then,
100%
then,
real.
Then if the point, I mean, we assume, I hope you at home assume the same, that this is a stage prop. This is not a close-up prop. Not because of the size, but in no part of the ad copy, it says it's a close-up trick. It is a stage prop, and it's very clearly stated on the ad copy. So if it's missing that part on the box, I apologize for that, but I think it's very clear for everybody that this is an old gag. We at Twister Magic, we didn't create that super late, that mean no, that, no. the throwing no. hammer. It's a very old gag,
yeah.
like the brick.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
like
yeah,
the
yeah.
foam brick. So basically what we try to do with this, because you can see we have a latex line of bottles, Coca-Cola vanishing.
The
that
bottles
have liquid.
Look really good.
Yeah, the yeah. bottles like, look really good.
So
really
what
good.
We try to do with this item, and you know, it became a big thing later, it is basically, of course, it says that in the box. It's a gag. And how the way I do it, it is to have it under my table or in any place when the audience can't see it. So you say, and I might understand, you might agree or disagree, because it's a cultural thing also, you know,
yeah.
in America you can get sued if you throw a hammer into the audience. Yeah,
we're
worldwide. Yeah, no, not the same worldwide. I mean, in Latin America, which I mean, hello, let's look. There is more than 20 countries in South America and in just Central America.
And it's okay.
It is, but it's not going to harm you. It is latex. It collapses
oh, right.
10
yeah,
times its size. Yeah. We're not talking about the real
oh,
one.
Okay.
It's a gag. You know, you say I'm going to throw a lightweight object, so you grab the gag, you throw it away, and that's it, period. So why in the box was a state the mentalism thing? Because I deeply believe the magicians should get a chance of creating new things. And but one of the suggestions was about doing a Russian roulette. Hundreds of people commenting trashing this on your Facebook page.
That's,
but there
not
were,
that's just not a way to make people buy six hammers.
Now, no, no, no. I'm not talking about six hammers. I'm talking about three hammers
honesty,
and a real one.
Honesty.
No, three hammers and a
three.
And
three.
Yeah, of course.
Have you ever used this for mentalism?
No, never. I have
come
just
on.
Said as a guy, but it's a possibility.
Serious mentalist.
Well, I mean, let's define serious mentalist, because we can be the whole show here.
Serious.
There's a fine line in between mentalism, like a real guy that have real powers, and the guy that does mentalism and comedy too.
I think with
you
mentalism,
gotta decide that point.
I think the more eyeliner you wear, the more serious you are as a mentalist.
The more
well,
I think
yeah.
is the general
yeah.
rule of thumb.
Now,
with that.
Yeah. As we did say, I don't think we're ever going to agree on that.
Well, I'll tell you who might like this.
It's a gag, guys.
I heard
it's just a funny guy.
I heard
you can do it,
the,
you cannot. It's not a big deal. But wait, before you
I'm
going to
give you a customer.
Yeah.
I heard that in the Fism close-up, Greg Wilson lobbed a Rubik's Cube into an audience and almost knocked someone out.
Yeah,
so you
he
might
actually
wanna,
nearly killed
so
them.
So you might want to come up with a latex Rubik's Cube and give it to Greg.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's...
We will consider it.
I like
it. But wait, before you talk about that, the point is what I was said, and we got in this stiff situation or rough situation, it was the fact that you mentioned that it was bad quality. So, for a latex prop, I don't think it's a bad quality. You might think if it looks real, it doesn't look real, you can use it for mental living, it doesn't fit my style. But it's not bad quality if you compare this to the ones that have been manufactured before. So that's basically.
Can I just say, he said that, not me?
Yeah.
I don't think it looks real.
And I'll
chuck it at John.
Yeah, perfect.
There you go.
Ooh,
now, okay. One thing I did like your doves.
Yeah. Oh, the doves are really cool. Because we had that. Have you ever seen the electric dove?
Oh, yeah.
Now that's crap.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I think it had a great idea behind, if you can make it real, but, you know, it wasn't, so you can take that out.
That's just so sad. A friend of ours used to have this in his wallet, I got to tell you, and it was so funny.
Yeah.
When he would go to pay for something and people knew he was a magician, and he would just open his wallet and it just used to pop up. It was absolutely so funny. I've actually got one of these off George, just so I can nick that gag
and
off
that's,
a friend
that's
of mine.
Obviously out
Funnily
now.
Enough, he's not using it these days.
It's going to come out by the time we're watching the show is going to be
and this
on the
thing
market,
that you did when you came on as well. This is the candle into the rose.
It's an idea by Nelson de la Prida, a great magician from Cuba that is here with us, and it's a product that Twister Magic it's putting in the market. Basically, what it is, it's a Fantasio candle. This is very important because, you know, Fantasio create this great line of products that unfortunately are not available anymore. Mm-hmm. But he created a smaller candle in order to do this trick, which combines two effects, the candle and the rose.
For stage production.
I tell you, looking around, you've got a lot of great products. Food to go.
We love your dove. We love your food to go. We like your rose. We hate your hammer, but don't worry about it. A lot of people stuck up for you.
I know. So,
it's all good.
Thank you for coming on. It takes a lot of guts to come on here and face
it. Really
nice
to be here.
Stand
the
up
product
for your
review.
Product.
All right.
And that deserves applause. George Iglesias.
Thank you.
So it's time to introduce somebody now who is representing probably the hottest producer on the planet.
No, forget about that probably stuff. Definitely the hottest producer.
They
on
have
the
their
planet.
Own branded close-up mats.
Yeah,
say
yeah,
no
yeah.
more.
They wouldn't come on the show unless we had this right here on the table.
We had to sign contracts and everything to get this guy on the show. It's Adam Wilber from Ellusionist. Come on round, Adam. Have a seat there. Adam, thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah, seriously, thanks for coming on, Adam.
Appreciate it.
You've been packed around your booth today.
Thought Blammo would be here, but that's all right.
No, he's not here. He's with Craig's wife at the moment and having a lot more fun. But a lot of people are looking at this smiley. I came to see this smiley effect. Absolutely unbelievable.
It's just mental. If you haven't seen this thing yet, right, you draw a smiley face. And then the thing just jumps all over the place from here to here to here. And it's super visual and it's really commercial.
And you don't just have to do the smiley face, which is...
Exactly.
Like, I saw it today. It was like the initials on a card. And it really is this clean that you've got the initials on the card and they like literally jump to the other card.
Ideally, a spectator signs a card, blank card. You put it in front of them. They see their signature. Anything you want. Like you said, initials, smiley face, prediction from here. There,
and
like
it really
that.
Is
literally
like that. The ink just jumps off the card. It's the craziest
and
thing.
And that's one of the things I think about pretty much you guys at Ellusionist, you don't release stuff all the time. You know, but when you bring something out, it's the sort of thing that you could see a street TV magician like Chris Angel or Dynamo or David Blaine, you could see them doing that.
Absolutely.
You know, it's the sort of thing that you... It's just cool. It's just cool.
Dynamo actually, from what I hear, has been doing pure smoke left and right.
Yeah. And guess what? Guess who he bought that off?
I would assume...
World Magic Shop.
Yes, he did.
Bought that off us, actually.
But that's the thing. You bring out so much
cool stuff. We get a lot of heat of, hey, what's going on? What's going on? People love it so much. Hey, it's been a month. And it's like, you know, things that are good take time. So.
Yeah, and you bring a lot of people into magic. You've got how many Facebook fans? Like,
what
billion?
Are we at, 130,000 now?
It's just like...
Pushing 150,000?
Yeah, and a lot of people that are in magic now and creating, they're there because of Ellusionist.
And hopefully for the right reason, right?
Yeah, exactly.
To get out and perform and give people memories.
Yeah, because back in the early days, you guys cut a lot of flack, but these days you're doing everything right and everything's just brilliant and it's always 100% up there looking really good.
Appreciate that. We're trying for it.
It really is great. Now, obviously you had Liquid Metal 2 with Morgan, which was a great project, and you kind of like moved into a different direction with the kind of metal bending and that kind of thing. And you've got two products, which we're going to get it off the sticks with right now. And this is a reworking of something you had out before.
Yep. This is version two.
Version two.
Version two of what we call the shift fork.
Okay.
And I don't do metal bending. I have a good friend that does beautiful metal bending.
Right.
He does his act, liquid metal two, and then he ends with this to solidify, right? You do this, they believe it, and then this thing, I'll do it to you. How
just,
about that?
Just convinces them of your power sort of thing
at
the end.
You basically walk away and take your applause and
cool.
And it'll be awesome.
Want to see it?
Do you want to get it off the sticks, as they say?
Awesome.
That's the one.
I'm glad I got to say that. So, again, pretend either you're in a restaurant doing table hopping or you've just done liquid metal today.
Yeah. Yeah. So you're saying, well, let's try something else.
Let me try something else. I've done this. I've been touching the fork a lot. Yeah, so let me see if you have the same kind of energy. I'll just have you open your hand, and we'll give a good shot of this. I'm going to put it into your hand here. I just want you to squeeze it. Hold on to it, yeah? And you know when you rub your hands together, you get some energy going on?
That feels weird straight
away.
It's
a strange thing, yeah? So imagine energy coming from your brain to your shoulder, down into your arm, to your forearm, into your hand, and then everything in your hand.
The strangest feeling.
Does it feel like
it's
moving?
It's pulsing. Like
maybe like the metal is actually
I'm not having you on here. It actually feels like it's got a heartbeat. And it's kind of like going like this inside my hand.
Keep focusing on it.
Yeah.
Imagine this top part pushing upward and the two ends by themselves bending down. From just the energy coming down from you right now. You squeeze a little harder. You think a little harder. It should really feel like it's pushing down hard. Without me touching it once, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's see what happens. Slowly, one finger at a time. Just open your hand.
That's brilliant.
And the beautiful thing, it's not a rubbery fork. It's a real fork. Take an end there. Feel that it's
metal.
That's
you feel brilliant. It's quite solid.
I do metal bending. I do liquid metal. And there's very little that you can do that's as strong as metal bending for a layman. We've talked about this. It's both liquid metal has been both yours and my top working.
It's
set.
In our number one set.
Yeah,
beautiful.
And I know we joke about my number
table
one set,
hopping,
but
number
it's
one set
right up there.
When you've got a tough table, that's what you start with at the table.
And that just takes it to a new level.
And with the beauty of this, there's a million ways to present it. In the hands is great. They feel it. You can have them pinch it here. It goes from straight. They hold it straight on, and they see it just bend down.
That's
and
brilliant.
Then that's what they're left with, right?
Fantastic. And you have a key as well.
The key just came out. This is brilliant.
This is brand
like
new.
Shift
this
key
is what everybody's
shift key.
Everybody's coming over to you
we
guys.
We sold out
and say,
in 2 days. This sold out in 2 days.
This is like I was there, like, and you said they've gone.
You were mobbing you,
It's brilliant. I do ring flight a lot. Ring flight's beautiful. One of my top things.
Yeah.
So imagine you do ring flight. You pull it out. Here's your ring. Let's try something else.
So that
beginning.
Can stay with your keys,
that's
with
way,
your ring flight.
That's
no
that's
problem at all.
That's a hotel room key, look. To
it
our
is.
Hotel.
Let's give some promotion to the beautiful hotel here. There you go. And if you want, it's room two. There you go. We'll be here all week, yeah. So this looks a lot more organic than saying, here's a key, yeah? So you pull it out. Same idea. We'll do it with you this time.
Okay.
Can you just hold your hand out?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
We'll place it in your hand there. Mm-hmm. Same any presentation you want.
You're right.
It feels it like feels it's... I'm not having you on. People are going to say, oh, no, we're saying something.
No.
It feels... even though me and Craig know what's going on, it is the weirdest sensation, this
that
thing in your hand.
That is really, really... I can't even describe it.
It's beautiful.
I can't even describe how weird that
well,
is.
I
that's
said,
just...
like, pulsing. As if it's got,
like... It's almost
as if
like,
it's
a, like a heartbeat,
like
yeah.
it's got a rock band inside it, and it's kind of like... sort of going like this.
That is crazy.
Again, one finger at a time, open it.
That's just mad.
The subtleties with this, there are, if you can do halfway, make it look like it's literally like rubber. Rub on, it bends, and then hand it to him. That's it.
That is absolutely brilliant.
So that shift key, shift fork.
So those are your two new items.
They are, yep.
I've got one more
and
question.
And Smiley.
And Smiley, which is also... I've got one more question. We've asked this to lots of people already so far these last few days. Brad Christian, okay, obviously.
Oh, yeah.
Mr.
We've
Illusionist.
All the guests.
Yes.
All the guests.
Everybody we've
this.
Asked this, right. Okay, Brad
everybody
Christian.
Who works with a big producer, Paul Harris.
Everyone. Alex Pandrea, the Blue Crown. We've asked everyone. Right, we want to know, One annoying thing about Greg Christian. I know you're going to say he's brilliant and he's wonderful.
Yeah, everybody says he's brilliant.
Annoying What's the thing? What's the thing that drives you insane?
Every single time, Adam, you're in that office, you're in these high-powered meetings, and you Brad go, just does that
Brad
thing that you just
Christian.
Go, God's sake, Brad.
There's got to be one thing.
Come on, Brad.
Tell us right now.
How much do you care about
Dish
your
the
job?
Dirt.
He's too nice of a guy.
Oh, that's such a cop-out. Come on, seriously.
He's so nice that you want to slap him.
Really?
Yeah.
Can anyone be that nice?
Talk to Brad Christian on the phone, yeah.
Really?
No, he's a nice guy. I mean, of course, there's things that you won't like about anybody. Certain people get you rubbed the wrong way. Brad Christian, I would consider, honestly, a friend and a great, great boss.
Is he good at, like, replying to text messages?
I don't text him.
Okay, is he good at sending emails and replying?
Absolutely,
yeah. Can you get him on the phone?
If I call from England on my phone right now, it's going to cost me $65 a minute.
But he normally he's good on the phone, right?
Yeah.
Paul Harris,
Alex, Pendrea.
Yeah, you need to learn something from Brad Christian.
No, Brad Christian is one of the better. Magic, we all know we get big egos and big heads. Yeah. Brad could have the biggest, and he's one of the more humble guys I've met. And yeah, you call
it's good
him
to know when you're running the coolest production company.
He's doing something right.
In the world.
Definitely.
He's doing that.
And we're very, very privileged that you joined
Pleasure.
Us on
Thank
the sofa.
Thank you for having me.
Adam Wilber from Ellusionist.
Well, that's it for this week.
That's it for this week's Wizard Product Review, our special report from the Fism convention. Thank you to all our guests. We'll see you next week, guys. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig. This is Adam.
Peace.